Hey, today we'll be unboxing the Moto Edge 2024, take a closer look at the device itself, and check out some cool features and tips and tricks for the device. So let's get started with the unboxing. For that, we need the box, and we unbox it. We have our phone nicely wrapped. We'll find there's a whole bunch of goodies, this nice USB-C cable. You get some pamphlets and your SIM eject tool. And there you have it, your Motorola phone, Edge 2024. One of the first things you'll see is the 50 megapixel camera at the back, faux leather backing. On the right side of the phone, you have your power button, your volume up and down. On the left side, you have another extra button for Motorola actions, microphone at the top, USB-C charging port at the bottom, along with the speaker, and your SIM card tray is just a SIM card. There's no SD card slot. Let's go ahead and start it up. It does tend to wobble. What I like to do for that is a simple thing called a case. This case is particularly nice. It's silicone, it just snaps on. It has a nice sliding cover on the back. If you worry about your camera, get a little ring stand, and it covers your curved screen as well. Okay, so let's quickly talk about this phone and some of the pros and cons. I like the design overall. It's nice to grip, lightweight. It feels good in the hand. Some of the downsides are this faux leather back can sometimes get like these greasy fingerprints, if you can see that. But I don't see that as a major downfall. The screen. I really like the inbuilt fingerprint reader. It works well. It is a really good display that gets really bright. I've never had a problem reading anything outside on bright sunny days. I believe it's P-OLED and it goes up to 144 hertz, which is amazing for a phone in this price range. I personally like the curved screen. I feel like it gives it a nice hold. The curved display gives you new opportunities for interaction. I personally like these edge light for notifications for incoming calls, alarms, and applications. But some people don't like the curved displays because it's hard to find screen protectors. If that's a problem for you, I'll leave a link to this screen protector that I got with curved edges. Another great pro is the battery. It comes with a 5000 milliamp hour battery, which lasts really long. And it supports turbo power charging, which feeds it 68 watts, so it charges really fast. Motorola claims a full day's power for 15 minutes. And it has 15 watts of wireless power charging, which is great if you don't like dealing with cables. The other pro is performance. It comes with 8 GB of inbuilt RAM with a 4 GB RAM boost. And it has a Snapdragon 7S Gen 2 processor. That's probably enough for most people, but if you're a heavy gamer, or if you do a lot of taxing things like editing videos on your phone, then you might want to spend a little bit more to get a more faster processor in a flagship device. But for the average user, it's fine. Let's quickly talk about storage. It comes with 256 gigabytes of inbuilt storage, which is a great amount for a device in this price range. Of course, no expandable SD card. If you tend to store a lot of things on your phone, then you might want to look for a phone with more storage. But these days, most people use cloud backup. So you can use Google Photos or Dropbox, Google Drive, any other provider to store your files. Let's talk about everyone's favorite thing, the camera. This phone has a 50 megapixel main Sony sensor. And it also has an ultra wide camera if you like taking those really wide shots. In terms of the camera performance, it's not great, right? You'll be fine with it if you're just taking average photos, but just note that it doesn't capture all of the fine detail. So if taking good pictures is really important to you, maybe this isn't the phone for you. But if you're like me and you just take a few pictures here and there, it's a great phone for that. Another pro for the phone is it's IP68 water and dust resistant, so I wouldn't take it into a swimming pool, but a little bit of light rain or something and it'll probably hold up fine. Finally, let's talk about the operating system. It comes with Android 14. Motorola has promised 2 years of major software upgrades and 3 years of security patch releases. This means that you'll definitely get Android 15. You might even get Android 16 when it comes out. But if you like to hold on to your phones for a long time, just know that you will stop receiving security patches after that 3-year mark. I just want to quickly summarize the pros and cons for you. Pro number one, great screen. Gets really bright. It has a high refresh rate. Excellent P-OLED screen at this price point. Second pro, the battery. It's a great 5,000 milliamp hour battery. It has fast charging and wireless charging. It's a solid win in my book. The third pro is the overall design is nice and sleek, and it is dust and water resistant. Some of the cons, the camera. It's a decent camera, but it's not gonna win any awards or anything, so if that's important to you, think twice. Software support. This phone, you'll only get software support for 3 years, which if you hold onto your phone for a long time, not great. The third con is the design, which I know I said is a pro, but here's some minor gripes I have with the design. These volume buttons on the side, they can be a little bit easy to press while they're in your pocket, so I'm not a big fan of these volume buttons. The faux leather in the back can attract fingerprints, which I'm personally not a fan of. And lastly, some people just don't like curved screens, but again, that's a personal preference. Overall, I don't think there's any major cons with this device for most people, but for the camera specifically, if you like taking professional quality pictures, this might not be the device for you. Let's quickly talk about one of the main things, price. Here's where it gets a little dicey. At the full price, I don't think this phone provides enough value. But if you're getting it at a discount from Amazon, which I'll leave a link in the description, or from a carrier deal, then I think it's a great phone for most people. What's your favorite thing about this phone? Let us know in the comments. All right, now, like I promised, here are a few tips and tricks for your Motorola Edge. This is my favorite thing about Motorola phones, okay? Chop chop to turn on your flashlight. Chop chop to turn it off. Twist twist, your camera. Twist twist again, front-facing camera. If the flashlight doesn't work for you, you might need to turn it on in your settings by going into gestures and turning on fast flashlight, as well as quick capture. While you're in here, you can also configure quick launch, which lets you double tap the back of your phone to take specific actions. I have mine set to go back to home, so when I double tap the back, it should take me back home. Just like that. Although I have found it to be finicky, so I don't really use that a lot. Another great feature of this phone is the sidebar. So you can turn this on, and that lets you swipe in from the edge to launch whatever you've selected as some of your favorite applications. The main tip that no one talks about is turning off your wireless printing, because that uses up a lot of battery in the background. So to do that, go into Connected Devices, Connection Preferences, Printing, Default Print Service, and turn it off. If you don't print from your phone, you probably don't need it. Here's how to take a screenshot. You can press the power button and volume down, and it's gonna show up here. And then you can crop this, write anything on it, and share this from the screen that pops up. Another way to take a screenshot is to use the multitasking button here, and then you'll see this icon. If you press that icon, it's gonna take a screenshot. And then again, you can go in and crop or write on it and share. The third way to use a screenshot is to use three-finger screenshot to turn that on. You need to go into your settings, gestures, and make sure it's on. And then once it's on, you can press and hold three fingers to take a screenshot. And then again, you have your menu where you can edit it and then share it and delete it if you need to. Another great feature to use is the split applications. So you will need to go into your gestures and turn on swipe to split. This will let you use multiple applications on the same screen. So for example, if I want to browse the web and use my calculator at the same time, I could swipe back and forth and press on my calculator, and now I can see them both at the same time. These can be any two applications that support this. So the Motorola Edge comes with this quick key on the left side. The first time you press and hold this, you should get a pop-up menu. But if you don't, you can go into your settings, go to gestures, and you can configure it here under quick button. You can turn on single press to play or pause music, turn on the recorder, screen record, or launch any application. You can turn on double press to turn on ready for. This is when you have your phone connected to your PC or a display. You can do things like mirror your phone or use your camera as a webcam, file transfers, and all that other stuff. Now, here's something that no one talks about, okay? There is a walkie-talkie mode, which if you turn on, you can press and hold the quick key to start using your phone as a walkie-talkie for whatever channel you have it configured in Microsoft Teams. Now, one of the great things about having a curved screen is you can use that as a new notification method. To turn that on, go to your settings, hit personalize, and your edge light. And here you can select if you want to use those for incoming calls, alarms, and app notifications. Now, here's how to check if your phone is unlocked. Go into About Phone, Device Details. If this network lock says unlocked, that means you can use it with any carrier. Now, if you want to root your phone, you'll need a bootloader unlock, which is different. To take a look at that, go into your About Phone, Device Identifiers, and then press your build number 7 times. You'll need to re-enter your PIN, super secure PIN there. That will now enable a developer options menu in settings. So you can go into developer options, and here you'll see whether you have an option for OEM unlocking. Make sure you turn that on, and that will let you unlock your bootloader. Now, this option might be grayed out for you, in which case you might need to stay connected to the internet for 7 days before this option becomes available. Just because this option is available doesn't mean you can actually unlock your bootloader and root your phone. Certain carriers don't allow you to unlock your phone at all. So for example, if you have a Verizon phone like myself, then you're out of luck. But if you do want to learn more about unlocking your bootloader and rooting your phone, I have another video linked in the description below where I walk you through that entire process step by step. The last cool feature I want to show you is how to use Google Assistant or the new AI Gemini model. To do that, just press and hold the home button or press and hold the power button. If this video helped, don't forget to hit like. Do you have a favorite tip that you want to share with the rest of us? Let us know in the comments. Now here's the bonus tip for getting rid of bloatware on your Motorola phone. First, download F-Droid. Once it's downloaded, go ahead and install it. It might ask you for permissions. Go ahead and provide those permissions. It's going to take a second to update those repositories. Once it's done that, you can search for Canta. So let's go ahead and F-Droid will need permissions to install it. So let's go ahead and provide those permissions. Make sure you proceed at your own risk. This could cause issues with the software on your phone, and so you have to be careful about what you uninstall using this application. I'm gonna go ahead and accept it. Okay, if you go back, it tells you that you need to install Shizuku. So let's go ahead and click on that link to download Shizuku. I'm gonna download it from GitHub. The link for this will be in the description below, but you can go to the releases page and download the APK file for Shizuku. Install Shizuku. Shizuku will require permissions for it to allow you to uninstall some of these applications. So we're gonna, there's a step-by-step guide that you can follow. Or if you're following along with me, you can start by pairing, allowing notifications, going into developer options. We enabled these earlier in the video, but if you haven't enabled this, you can go into your settings. About Phone, Device Identifiers, and click your build number 7 times. Continuing with Shizuku, it tells you to turn on wireless debugging and to pair with a device code. So we're gonna do that now. Go to Developer Options, scroll till you find USB debugging and turn on wireless debugging. And then after that, once you click into wireless debugging, you'll see that you can pair with a pairing code. So let's do that. And you can see our pairing code here. Going into my notifications, I can enter that code. Okay, pairing successful. I can now go back to Shizuku and start it. And here it says service started. now I can go back to Canta, which I installed, and I can filter. For example, my phone came with this device pulse application and this My Sights application that I don't really need or want on my phone. So I'm going to go to Canta now. I'm going to search for pulse, select that. I'm going to search for sights, select that. And then I will press delete. And it's going to ask me if I want to uninstall those two applications. And I'll say okay. And now if I go back, you'll see that I don't have that pulse or that My Sights thing. If I want to bring it back, I can just go here and go to My Sights, for example, reinstall it, and it should now be back. Okay, so that was a bonus tip to clean up any bloatware from your phone and hopefully help your phone run faster. Do you have any other tips or favorite features? Let us know in the description below. If this video helped, don't forget to hit like and check out this other video on rooting your Motorola phone to make the most of it.